looks good, doesn't work. Okay, so the idea is this. For example, fader number 2 is actually working properly, as you can see. But fader number 1 tends to fuck up. As you can see, first of all, it doesn't go to the max, and as you can see, it moves a bit. Now, I already did try cleaning this one, and it did not work, so I'll be disassembling this console and replacing it with a new one. Now, I actually bought, I think I bought the original one, I'm not quite sure. Anybody can print this thing, so yeah. So, let's disassemble the console, and well, let's try to repair it. So, first of all, there are like millions of screws in here. So, that's something that all needs to be dealt with. So, here we go. You know what? There is a smarter way. So, two in here and two in here. It's good that this thing is easy to disassemble. So, there are two, three, and these four screws, and I believe this shielding has to go off as well. There is a ground in here, so don't forget to connect this thing later on. And this one is black, so I will be marking it. And there is one more in here. And this one is actually different, so okay. I think there was some soldering involved, but yeah. And as you can see, this one is smaller. This one goes directly to the motherboard. So, I think that I need to remove these screws as well from the rear. One more, okay. So, one more thing to disassemble is this. Just push it up and remove the cable. Okay. Ground should be removed as well. Yeah. So this is the screw that is ground. Okay. And there you have it. Let me show you the other angle. So all of this thing needs to be disconnected. All of these. This thing as well. Let's see if I can pull this thing. Yes, there you have it. And well, there are a lot of things that need to be disconnected, but you get the idea. And also this thing needs to be pulled up. Not the greatest system, I would say. Okay. The other side as well. Now, I still need to disconnect well everything. There are so many things to disconnect in here. again, easy to repair. Just a second. Second one as well. And this thing needs to be cut because fun times. No, it doesn't fit. I know I didn't cut it before. Okay, is there anything else to remove? Okay, so as you can see, there are a lot of cables that need to be removed. So part one complete. Okay, so the next thing, since we need this central part only, this is the part that I will be removing. There are so many screws in here. Okay. Now this is actually shielding. This thing has been actually grounded beautifully, so at least something. But before I continue, I'm gonna let my friend in here remove all the knobs. Have fun!
Thank you.
And today we are drinking Lashko. Not the greatest beer, but okay beer. So I'll be actually pausing this video until he finishes. So yeah, one eternity later. Upon removing all of this, I still need to remove this one, and there is one bolt underneath. Okay. So there are millions of screws, and this plastic also needs to be removed. So let's do that. But first of all, I'll need to remove this part. So there are two more screws that hold this thing as well. There are so many screws, seriously. That's the reason why I actually dislike repairing such consoles.
This is a motherboard for headphones, channel select and crossfader.
Exactly. Exactamundo. Okay. So I only need to remove one screw in here, and now there are actually all of these silver ones need to be removed that are in the circle, and my god, there are plenty of them. Okay. And I'm guessing this plastic is some kind of protection for something, maybe dust or something like that, who knows. Okay. Somebody in Pioneer was like, oh yeah, it's easy job. Cheers. What can possibly go wrong?
Perfect Sunday.
Exactly. By the way, this console needs to be operational tomorrow. So yeah.
Yes.
You know, there is a new version of Winamp out.
Without a mix.
Exactly.
Tomorrow is New Year's Eve, so we must repair it.
Yeah, definitely. So, always a good time. Okay, but I will need to remove all of these as well. There's like a ton of screws in here. think that this should solve our problem. And if I'm not actually wrong, and I think I might not be, after we remove this thing will be free. I will see. But yeah, one eternity later, just a second. Oh yeah. So yeah, there are like 30 screws at least. Okay. Just a second. Add my tool. There is some sticky tape underneath it. Okay, I guess that should be it. And yeah. Now you need to remove all of the screws. Good thing I do not need to put this thing back together. Oh wait. Oh wait. Keyword wait. Okay. And these screws are smaller than the ones on the back, so be careful with that. Now there are so many piles that I can have. Anyway, so the next thing is actually to remove all of these. Yeah. This will probably be the solution to all of our problems. My finger. Have fun.
Thank you.
I'll be back. Well, be back after he finishes. These two need to be removed as well. Everything needs to be unscrewed. Oh, bloody hell. So you'll be the judge how easy this console is to repair. So I'll actually try to push it from here. This thing has actually been removed. Wait for it. Fun times. Now, believe it or not, wait. So, and the removing the fader will actually be the easiest part. Seriously. I never thought that that would be the case. Anyway. The one that is faulty is this one, yeah? Is that right? Number one?
Yes.
So, let's unscrew this thing. And let's turn on my soldering iron. But you know, if you're doing this thing for the first time, I don't know whether I would recommend it or not. Anyway, there are only four, which you need to remove, four connectors, four pins, and yeah, let's do that. Now I do need to turn on my soldering iron. So yeah, this is definitely not easy to, well, unsolder and repair and whatnot. Add a bit more so I can. Oh, this is very dirty. So this tip is actually a bit falling apart, I would say, but what can I do? Now let's try to pry this thing off. Okay, this one has been removed and this one has been removed as well. So now basically all I need to do is put the new fader in and screw this thing, and this should be it. And this is the new one, and it's actually not Alps, it's Alpha. Go figure. But then again, so is this one. So I guess this is the original one. That's interesting. Maybe it's proprietary or something, I'm not quite sure.
How much fader cost?
I have no idea.
A few dollars.
$15 maybe.
15?
15, maybe 20. But if they actually used Alps, it would be way better. I'm not quite sure what the hell is with this tip, seriously. It was actually that easy to resolder it, but yeah, I'm not actually pretty, to be honest, satisfied with the design of this console, because in order to well, repair this thing, you actually need quite a lot of time. Now this thing has actually been soldered on and it actually looks good. I'm seeing actually quite a lot. Anyway, so now we need to put everything back.
Master key in center.
Where? Okay. Okay, so master
key and two loads up here, and I think
this is Q, and this one is Q as well. And load goes in here, and load goes in here as well. Okay. Yeah, and I forgot to put this thing back. So, moral of the story, always check if you put everything back. And I actually know a guy that is dying to continue to placing this thing back. So let's hook up the crossfader. and these long ones go in there. And to be fair, there's quite a lot of ground in here, so everything is grounded, so this console is actually done properly. I quite like that. Although, as I said before, it is a hassle to disassemble it. So everything has actually been screwed in, and this thing could use a cleaning, but not today. Okay, let's place this thing back. And now, there are 1 million screws left. So how easy this thing is to repair, well, you'll be the judge, but yeah, I would say not that easy. Definitely.
Easy.
Yeah. Okay. Now, the fun part.
The trillions of wires.
Yeah, the trillion of everything actually. So this aluminum part goes in here, and it is a bit harder to mount, but yeah, not revolutionary hard, I would say. Right. And this thing, the ground on this console is actually awesome. Just for it. Okay. Yeah, this thing goes in here. And no. We need to put this thing back. Okay. This one goes through here. I believe that the black one is the ground. Is it the black one? Oh. Yeah, it is the black one. Okay. And where is the black one? In here. What is the black one? Yes, this one.
This is one more.
Yeah. This one is for the ground. Mm-hmm. And now we need to place the rest in. So, what's next? Yeah, this thing, why not? Okay. Oh, these are the screws. For this one, they are smaller, and this thing actually needs to be grounded because it has a wire for ground. Okay, so the next thing is I need to hook everything back, and let's see how this thing goes and where this thing goes. Okay, so this one goes in here, and this one should go in here, I believe.
Every connector is different size, so exactly. You can't miss one.
In theory.
In theory.
And the missing ground goes actually ground that was actually missing goes in here.
Stupid ground.
You have been grounded. Okay. So many puns for no reason.
And the wires lead you where to connect it.
Exactly. Now I don't need to connect this one as well. But again, you actually cannot fail while connecting this. We will be trying to turn this thing on before I assemble it, because if this thing does not turn on, we are screwed. Yeah. Now this thing, okay, this one, this one goes in here. Now I need to screw this thing back in. Okay, so this thing and these two go in here, and actually we don't have any screws missing, I believe, which is nice. It's always nice.
It's a rare.
Yeah. Well, missing. I don't want to have any extras, but I do have an extra. Where did this motherfucker go?
Yes, where is it?
Okay, these four go in the rear and here. Okay, so let me show you. The last four go in here. But I have one screw extra. Why? I hate when I have one screw extra. I don't. I found out where it goes. It actually goes in here. So, no extra screws.
This is like a puzzle game.
Well, I wouldn't call it a game, but yeah, definitely. Now, let's try to turn this thing on before I assemble everything. I will be placing this thing back, actually. But yeah, let's try to hook up the laptop and let's see whether this thing will turn on. Let's turn this thing on and let's connect it to a computer. So, let's see whether we have the same issue or not, whether this thing is working or not. Okay, so this one, number two, works, and number one, as you can see, it goes all the way to the top. So basically it was a crossfader, which is, I guess, awesome. Well, there you have it. This repair is done and we can actually screw in the back, and that's it for this video. If you like this video, please click thumbs up. If you didn't, click thumbs up. Always click thumbs up. Bye.